Hello and welcome. Today I'm gonna try a water purity tester, the TDS tester, to measure the ppm values in water. This is parts per million, solid parts, dissolved minerals. So this is TDS 3, version 3. I don't really know much about them, but I know that they measure the conductance, electricity. So it has two electrodes, a few buttons, and it, depending on the how it conducts electricity, this is what I understand. It will decide how many particles of minerals are dissolved in the water. So this is the TDS meter measuring ppm values, and this is the tap water, and the value here for my tap, it's you have to put it in the water, it's about 500. It's around 500 from the tap. So it's not great, but okay, it's acceptable. It depends on the area where you live. In some places there might be less minerals, in some places more. A high TDS value or ppm value doesn't really mean that the water is bad, it just means it's more hard water, dissolved, more minerals are dissolved in the water. So it might be a good thing actually. If you really want to make a really extensive test, you have to test for heavy metals and bad contaminants. So I'm gonna try the water filter. I have this Brita water filter, and the cartridge hasn't been changed in a while, maybe a few months. Normally you change it, I think, every month. I'm not sure. Write in the comments how you change your Brita filters and if they work. So you see the cartridge was the same, it was also 500. So here is the new cartridge. It's brand new, so I'm gonna clean the filter, the container, with water and citric acid to dissolve the solids, and now I'm installing the new cartridge. You see, it's pretty easy. They say to run it a few times, two or three times, and throw the water away and then use the water. So I'm gonna do that, and we're gonna check how the values change for this TDS meter, ppm values, parts per million. And yeah, it's ppm values, parts per million, and this is the first time, 460. It's not bad actually, for 450 something, 460. So it seems to be doing something, at least it's not useless. So here I'm using the water that is for drinking in the tap. This is not filtered, it's just direct from the tap. And I'll do the same. Okay, let's see now how it looks like. Yeah, I put too much water before. This should be not too much, so it doesn't go too much in the water. Just all the thing that needs to go in the water is the electrodes of the meter. So yeah, TDS 3 meter, and it also measures temperature. Imagine, I don't use it for temperature, only for parts per million. 470, almost 480. So yeah, 480, it goes a bit higher, but it's still a bit lower than 500, how it was before, but it's not a big difference. So I'm not sure how much of really what how much is doing this filter. It's filtering a little bit, but not as much as I thought. I thought it would go down to 300, I don't know, at least 400. So I'm gonna change the water again, refill it, the same as before. And I wanna try something else here. I did a small experiment to use just mineral water, plain mineral water, and to see how this one looks like. This is interesting to see. How much do you think the water has from the bottle, the bottled water? Well, yeah, now you can't guess because you're seeing it on the screen. So yeah, this one is much lower, 180, 160, depending on the how you move the water, but 185, let's say it's 185. That's a big difference. It's under 200, so it's really 190, 185, 190. It's really amazing compared to the tap water. Yeah, that's the reason to buy the bottled water or to filter your water with something better than a Brita filter. Maybe to have a really powerful filtering system to bring the PPM level lower than 200, I would say. So it's nice to see that this meter actually works, first of all, and I will put links in the description for the meters if you want to get one yourself and check the water. And if you have one already, make sure you check your water and let me know in the comments below how is your water level for the PPM value on the TDS meter. I would say this is a pretty good test, and at least just to be sure that the value is not very high. 500 is still kind of okay. So the filter drops it to 480, 475, so that's not really a big difference, and I'm not sure if it's really worth it. Okay, now it shows for 458, 460. So 460, 470, 480. Yeah, you decide, and let me know in the comments if you think this Brita filter is worth it. They are pretty expensive actually, so still it does something, but not as much as the bottled water. And I believe there are fixed filters that do a much better job at filtering the water. I would say it still might be worth it to have one of these filters just to be able to quickly filter the water if the PPM value is higher. This one, I'm not sure if it's worth it. I think the water is fine as it is from the tap. So yeah, you let me know in the comments below if you think I should use this filter or it's a waste of money, or if there is another filter, a filtering system, let me know which filtering system is best, that you think it works better, that filters much better. For now, that the bottled water is great, it's amazing. So, and the tap water is pretty good too. Let me know in the comment section below what you think about this, and that's it. Thanks for watching, subscribe, like and share, and I will see you next time. Bye.